Donc nous allons y aller. 1, 2, 3.
Joyeux anniversaire. Joyeux anniversaire. Joyeux anniversaire.
Anniversaire, il ne veut plus rien faire. Ah, c'est en vérité un couple, et là nous avons Lucky et Justine. Et c'est le Rotaract Europe. Sachant que dans la salle, il y a le Rotaract France. Allez, debout, toi. Et il y a un nombre incalculable de Rotaract Club. Allez! Mais, tous les anciens que je suis et que nous sommes aussi des Rotaractiens. Allez, on les écoute!
Bonjour à toutes, à tous. My name is Lucky, and I'm the Vice President of Rotaract Europe.
Hi everybody, my name is Justin Hachalabris. I am the President for ERIC. Before we begin, I would like to say we are very grateful to be here today, to be with so many active and ambitious people in society who believe in sustainability and are trying to achieve sustainability now and for the future. We would also like to thank Gerard, Serge, and Skull for organizing this and inviting us. So thank you everyone for that. So I'm the president of the European Rotaract Information Center, but we like to call it Rotaract Europe. We are a multi-district information organization that aims to connect, share, and collaborate throughout all of Europe. We have a composition of 24,000 members around Europe, which is 115 districts in 46 countries. This year is our 30-year anniversary, so we've developed a lot of initiatives, particularly in our communication channels, in order to celebrate this year. So some of the innovative things we've been doing is a monthly educational webinar, as well as a monthly newsletter, which is sharing content, projects, and other events going on around Europe.
Today, we have a question for you. What do you think is going to be the biggest challenge for humanity in the next future? You can answer if you want. If you want to raise your hand, vous pouvez répondre si vous voulez. There's someone that has an answer. Yes?
Yes, please.
Resources.
Sorry?
Resources.
Okay, someone else? Yes?
The water.
Water. Yes, it's a resource, yeah. Someone else?
Yes.
Peace.
In a university in Milan, the biggest challenges that are perceived by people for the next future are terrorism, climate change, war, poverty, diseases, immigration, water scarcity, alien invasion, and food scarcity. Now, let's think about them for a second. If we take out terrorism, and of course, we take out alien invasion, which is not likely to happen soon, we have climate change, war, poverty, diseases, immigration, water scarcity, and food scarcity. If we consider climate change, which is the biggest number of people answer climate change, we actually can notice that all of them are connected to each other, and they're connected to climate change. Because of climate change, we're having worse conditions, so we're having diseases. We're having poverty, because there is a lack of resources. So we have food scarcity and water scarcity. And we have war, because there is a war over resources. And also we have immigration, because people cannot live in the place where they're living anymore, because the conditions are unbearable. The World Bank just released a study that was saying that by 2050, there's going to be millions of people going away from Africa or from Latin America because the conditions cannot allow them to live there anymore.
So you're probably wondering, what can we do about this? Last August, our board came together and we started to think, what can we do in order to bring everyone together and to fight these problems? We looked at what we thought were the current problems and the future problems. We looked at Rotary's 6 areas of focus and the 17 sustainable development goals. And what we did was we created our own themes for the year, which are green, health, growth, and peace. Today we'll focus on green. Green, the idea, as you saw from the video, is to support the green economy, to develop a sustainable future so that we don't run out of resources, as they're very scarce. To do so, we've created some ambitious targets, one of which was to plant 30,000 trees in honor of our 30-year anniversary. We chose this goal because of the 30-year anniversary, but also because it's aligned with President Ian Grizzly's goal of each Rotary Club having each member plant one tree. And I'm proud to say that today we've already planted 32,000 trees in Europe. In addition to that, we've had a strategic relationship with Forest App, which is a phone application that when the user is turning it on, it begins to count hours. And the more hours you use, the more trees that they plant. So we have a lot of people in Europe using it. During our 3 annual conferences, we also have social projects. In Slovenia, we planted trees. In Lithuania, we built birdhouses for migrating birds. And in Antwerp, we will be packing lunches with Rise Against Hunger. In addition to that, we have a webinar on sustainable tourism in the coming weeks. So at a club level though, you see that what we're doing is consolidating all of the projects that are happening and informing others what's happening so that they can collaborate. So far we've counted over 7,000 hours of volunteer work and over 15,000 people, I would say that it's 15,000 people that have been participating in these projects and an impact of 50,000 euros. So through these themes, we've been able to really bring people together through the common ideas and to really combat the challenges that we face.
So coming back to the first thing we were talking about, the most important contribution that European Rotaractors gave to their society is related not just to climate change purely, but to solve all the consequences of climate change. So for example, we have this partnership with Rise Against Hunger. In 2 weeks, we're all going to meet in Antwerp, in Belgium, and we're gonna pack 30,000 meals that are gonna be sent to a poor country in order to give food to the children when they have the lunch break at school.
To combat war, we have one amazing initiative called MUN, Model United Nations, and what they do is they are working towards a more peaceful society through diplomacy and multicultural dialogues on significant problems that we face. And in fact, in the next month there will be an MUN conference in New Delhi, and in September there will be one in Lithuania. And these are Rotaractors and Rotarians working together in Europe.
We have projects by big realities such as Rotaract France, with their service Esperantet, which is a service made together with Rotary, you probably are aware of that, to finance research against diseases. So we are acting also against diseases.
And to combat immigration in Cyprus, we have a lot of initiatives, and one in particular is at a refugee camp. Something that we noticed from dialogues with other countries that have refugees was that it wasn't as much of a problem to integrate refugees into the country, but more or less for the refugees to integrate amongst each other, because they're all coming from different backgrounds and different countries. So what they've done is they've established a football field for them to play sports with each other, and also partnered up with other organizations, teach them languages, provide them laptops so that they can learn more and be involved and create a common identity.
We have examples such as the Club of Florence, which is helping poor people in Mumbai in India. It's out there helping people with sight problems in order to help them to see again.
And to combat water scarcity in Treviso, Italy, they are providing educational seminars to children to teach them about water security and water planning.
So, as you can see, Rotaractors around Europe, together with the organization Rotaract Europe, but also at local level in their single clubs, are having millions of projects which are helping the planet to be a better planet in the future. But the thing is that we are acting now. So this is a call to all Rotaractors to keep it up, and to all Rotarians to look at us and to help us, because this is essential. The collaboration between Rotary and Rotaract is the key, because we now are thinking that we have a problem to face in the next future, but actually we have to solve this problem now. There's no next future, because actually the future is now, and the future is us.
So in an effort to make sure that we all take action today, we packaged seeds in these little packets, and we have one for all of the panelists and anyone else who would like some, so that when you leave today, you can go and plant some trees.
It's actually flowers, not trees, so don't expect trees. If you would like to get some, you can come see us. We have plenty of them. So just please come, and they're beautiful flowers. You're gonna call a lot of butterflies also.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.